Bobby here from Elm City Trailer in Woodbridge, Connecticut, with my son, with Blue, who runs the shop. We're going to do a tag team video for you today. On a standard Diamond C fleet neck, aka gooseneck, but we're going to kind of come at it with from a different point of view with two of us. So for those of you who know the Diamond C's, you may get something out of it. For those who don't, you'll get a lot out of it. This one, we're using this particular trailer for a video because we sold it to our friend Jim, and we're going to make his trailer famous, and then we're going to borrow it and beat it up, and we may even do weird stuff on it. But
shout out to Jim.
Yeah, Jim. All right, so this is a FMAX 210. Now, Diamond C's, the 210 represents two 10,000-pound axles. So, Noah, get a whole look at this thing. This baby is a 28-foot, so that's 23 flat plus a 5-foot dovetail. It's 25,000 GVWR. It is a work of art. So Blue and I are going to throw a little bit at you together. So Blue, why don't you hit it in the front?
Starting in the neck up front here, going through the engineered beam that Diamond C has created. This is all one-piece neck up here, 12-inch engineered beam. Going right down into a 16-inch cambered I-beam for the frame of the trailer. Couple options up here. They got two 25,000-pound two-speed jacks with drop leg. That's an option.
Two 12,000-pound jacks 25. Would have been standard.
Yeah.
All right, come on down this way, Noah.
You got a retractable step here, which is standard, coming out, which old guys like this guy over here.
Oh, needs. It's good for the old guy with a handle, baby.
With a handle, right down the side here, we have a stake pocket rub rail, which is standard. So on top of that, these D-rings are not standard. This is an option that my father had added for Jim when he ordered it.
Now let me jump in here. So here's the deal with D-rings. You can add whatever you want, anywhere you want, any angle you want. Since the stake pockets and rub rails are standard, Diamond C makes a really nice D-ring that's removable, that slides in and has a ring on the top. A lot of guys don't want this because if they're sliding the skids on and off, this gets in the way, or whatever, they're carrying plants, material, whatnot. Jim is just going to be hauling primarily tractors and equipment and wanted D-rings everywhere. So we put four per side. That's kind of how we ended up with that. We also upgraded the deck. It's normally pressure treated and Jim wanted oak. So Diamond C offers white oak. That's where we went. More standard stuff. Well, more options, I should say, that I did when I talked to Jim. This center light is a clearance light and a blinker. We added a couple extra clearance here. There's usually one on each end. So I like to add a couple extra. It looks nice. So I added two extra sets. And while we added lights, you'll see we added backup lights to this, which is an option. So it's wired in, you hit reverse, you're gonna get, there's four LED white lights in each brake light. So that means there's 16 of them. But Blue tapped into the harness and added these because Jim's old too and can't see. These are nice. What are these?
Those are, that's a Beyer 7,000 lumen LED cube, you can call it. Mounted on a swivel, so aiming right out next to the tires because this is what you want to see when you're backing up at night with the trailer. It's your pivot point when you're going around rocks or anything like that, whatever.
You can come in closer though and check this out. You know, and he'll set everything the way he wants, but they're really nice. So you got lights out back and you're lighting up the side. All right, you're gonna oil that, man, and you spread.
Yeah. So these 10,000-pound axles on this trailer, it's got 48-inch spread, which is standard oil bath axles. Those dualies, obviously, you can get this in a super single as well.
Right.
So,
load height is.
Oh yeah, with the pierce beam frame, which is mostly standard on a lot of manufacturers, but it gives you a 33-inch deck height, which also a good thing for older gentlemen like this guy right here.
It's harassing me. But I'm only 5'9 and it's still low, so that's good. All right, I'm 5'9 on a good day. Let's go, let's keep going, Noah. All right, I'll do the ramps, speaking of old guys. All right, so you get these trailers, you can get a flat deck with a slide out ramp, you can get a hydraulic dovetail. This, here's the deal with that. It gives you a ton of possibilities. So you can use equipment, you can use skids, you can put all kinds of material on a full flat deck. Hay, which is what we use it for, is great. But if that's gonna be in the way for a bucket or a boom or something, basically, when you lift them up, you can leave them here. You see how easy that came up, by the way? So this will lock here or down. Let me show you how easy that was again for the rest of you old guys. If I drop it, come right here for a minute, Noah. That's how it is. It's heavy. It's a lot of steel, but it's not heavy to lift because of the spring. So when you pick it up, you can stop right here. It balances. Then when you want to put it down, even for the old guy, that's how nice the springs are. So 5 foot dovetail when you go with these ramps. So you really got a 10 foot load angle and it's not high to begin with. So you can really put just about anything up there without a lot of problems. Show them in front, inside please. So you can get the angle filled dove and ramp, or if you want to opt for wood, you can do that. This is the most popular. Let it go. Easy. Easy. What else, sir?
Back here, those are showing the lights that...
get in there close, Noah.
As he mentioned earlier, the reverse lights, which are option, again, they come in right into the taillights. The ICC lights, your license plate holder with the light is right on the back of the MAX ramp right here. Easy to see. Same thing going up this side, pretty much. Got the other step.
Now, torque tube. This thing wouldn't come standard at 28 feet with a torque tube, but we added one for Jim because he thought it was a good idea, and I definitely thought it's a good idea for what he's hauling and how he's hauling it.
Yeah, with the big machines and tractors he's got, you know, they got one big lump of weight sitting somewhere. And torque tube's great for having it not flex and
you want to get under here, Noah? Can you get that low, buddy? Get right under and get that tube.
And right under here, we got an underswung toolbox. And our other reverse light that I mounted right here. This box is lockable, color matching. The lid's held out by chains. You can put stuff on it. You don't have to worry about it breaking or anything like that. It can fit binders, chains, anything that you're hauling, blocks, straps. You could put these, you could put one on either side or two. You can get a bigger one.
You can mount them anywhere you want. You know, like we did one if we had a slide track, you know, it wouldn't be resetting no more because you'd have a slide track for your ratchets. You can put them in front and back, left, right, anywhere you want is fine. Here. Noah, get up here. So, a couple other things. So option-wise, these are options, and you can get one or two. These are deck lights. So these are wired into the breakaway battery. So, like at night, if you wanted to load his tractor before he's hooked up, and you can load this thing if your wheels are chucked without being hooked up, but your lights will work without being plugged in because they're wired in. And they're LED, they don't use a lot of juice. While you're up here, you'll see this is an option. This is a winch plate, and I talked him into this, and he's not sure what he wanted to do for a winch, so we didn't go with the whole winch yet. He has a few of his own. He wasn't sure what he wanted to do, how he wanted to do it, but it's already here. It was welded in and painted and matches, so he's done. Obviously, your spare is here. If you went for a trailer with a deck on the neck and you can do a bolt on and add it later, which he almost thought about doing, and he may end up doing it, then you can make this on a the spare mount drop down, so you'd unload it from the bottom instead of coming from the top. And if you look up there, there's the breakaway battery up there, and you get a look at the massive neck on the I-beam. So don't fall, Noah. All right, so last step,
toolbox right up in the neck, which is standard. It's on a gas pot, opens up nice and easy. If you got stuff in your hands, you could look in here. We got chains and binders in here. Huge toolbox, real deep. So this one, even without the underslung box on the side, if you don't want to opt for that option, this will fit everything that you need and more, pretty much. So.
Lockable gas props. Storage, you're never going to have enough storage. I mean, they got dunnage racks, you got extra boxes, there's a ton of ways to add. Even here, this is the standard ball. You can go up with the adjustable one, they're square. You can do hydraulic jacks. There's a ton of options. You know, not that Jim cheaped out at all, because he did buy a really nice trailer. Well, you know, he's older. Hydraulic jacks would have been kind of nice, but anyway. Two-speed 25K jacks are awesome. You can lift anything. He could have that thing loaded with equipment and have no problem getting that up in the air. Anyway, all right, we're going to let Jim go. Jim, congratulations on your new trailer.
Thanks, buddy.
Coming, Blue and Bobby, coming at you from Elm City Trailer in Woodbridge, Connecticut. Check us out online. It's elmcitytrailer.com. We're on Facebook. We're on, what else are we on?
We're on Instagram.
Yes.
YouTube, so.
Yeah, check out the YouTube.
Check us out. Like, share, comment, and let us know what you think.
Thanks a lot, guys. Have a good one. Thank you for watching.